All right, this is uniform motion problems warm up. So we're going to get used to the formula that is distance equals rate times time. I have it backwards because we're going to plug in the rate and the time and then multiply them. Okay, so Dara is traveling at 40 miles per hour. That's our rate. How far will she travel in 6 hours? That's our time. And the whole thing is to make sure that your times match hours, hours. And so when we multiply them, you get 240, and it's that unit right there, which is miles. And that's it. So how far will she travel in T hours? Same speed for T would give us 40T. And this is what our problems are going to look like because we're going to be looking for either the rate or the time. Okay, so like this one. Jim has been traveling at X miles per hour. So X. How far will he travel in 6 hours in terms of X? Well, that's 6X. All right, so let's now try it with two people. So, Liz is traveling at X miles per hour. Leanne is traveling at twice the speed of Liz. So Liz is traveling at X, Leanne is traveling at 2X. Okay. How far will Liz travel in 3 hours? So, 3. That's 3X. Leanne is 2X. How far will she travel? 6X. Twice the speed. Twice the distance in the same amount of time. And that's it. So this is how it's going to look with two problems. You're going to be given two values. You plug them in for each and multiply. All right, then this is the last one that we're going to use as a warm-up. So it says James and Sylvia. Those are our two people. So we have James and Sylvia. James has been traveling at 22 miles per hour. Sylvia is traveling at 33 miles per hour. James has been traveling for T hours, so that's his time. So James is done. He's at 22T for his formula. Sylvia, though, has her comparison with that T. It says Sylvia left 30 minutes before James. Well, if she left before James, here's Sylvia. She heads out. And then 30 minutes later, that's when James starts. So it takes him a while to catch up, which means he had less time, which means Sylvia has more time. But you can't put 30 because that's minutes, that's hours. So it's got to be 30 over 60. But we don't want the fraction, so we reduce it and it becomes 0.5. And so when we multiply it, it's 33 times t plus 0.5. And that's their distances, their formulas. All right, so that's the basics for all of these uniform motion problems. This is our setup. The main start for all of it is listing our quantities, and this is what we have.